It's no surprise that most of my earliest videos have very few views. And I'm not complaining, nobody needs to watch those. Please leave them alone. But a video that keeps popping up in my notifications 11 months after it was published is my Wings of Fire hybrid videos, which I've recently discovered has over 14k views. When did this happen? I'm in shock. Anyways, that video, I guess, did pretty well, and people seem to like it, so let's do it all again. This time, I've had almost a year more of experience in tribe headcanons to incorporate into the design, so expect them to be even more over the top, unnecessarily complicated, colorful, and overall better. So let's just dive into the first design, shall we? The first hybrid combination that I got was a Sandwing-Icewing combo. This got me pretty excited. Icewings are a tribe I have a bunch of design headcans for, and Sandwings have some pretty unique features that are a lot of fun to incorporate. I started by googling some concepts I had, more specifically, desert and winter. This led me to one of my main inspirations for the design, which was the imagery of the sandstone red rock cliffs of places like Utah covered in snow. The contrast of the warm red and cool blues and purples is something I'm such a sucker for, and I thought that making the character primarily red-orange with some lighter pale speckling could make it look really neat. This led me to my second inspiration, as it reminded me of a certain animal with this exact kind of patterning, my favorite breed of horse, the Appaloosa, more specifically the red roan variation. Another very small spark of inspiration I got was for the darker stripes and spots along the character's neck and shoulders and back, and those were based off of a sort of speckling that's sometimes found in these types of red rocks, which I later discovered was called Tifoni, which I later decided to name the character. Some more tribe-based design features that are from some of my personal headcanons are the antlers and fur of Icewings. Overall, I really, really love this design and think it's very cool. The next combination was for a Leafwing-Silkwing hybrid, and the first thing that came to mind were butterflies that look like leaves. When I went to search this up to get some design ideas, I stumbled across a plant called the Oxalis triangularis, also known as the false shamrock or butterfly plant. They were so pretty and instantly gave me some ideas. I went for a very triangular theme with the patterns, for obvious reasons, and I tried to combine the two main colors of the plant. Green and purple are my two favorite colors, and it's always such a fun challenge to make them go well together, and I think I succeeded here. As for the features of the dragon itself, I tried to emphasize the leafiness while also trying not to lose the silkwing of it all. I added leaves to the antennas and made the wings look very leaf-like and used bright colors to keep the whole silkwing feel. I decided to name this character Oxalis after a plant I based it off of. While I still really like the design, it's probably the one I'm least happy about. But I think I did a decent job of combining the two tribes and making a good design. The final hybrid combo I got was a Nightwing-Hivewing. This made sense to me, as in the books, apparently Hivewings are descended from Nightwings, but I had much less inspiration regarding the design for this one as compared to the other two. I don't draw Hivewings very often, and as a result, don't really have any unique design features for them, but luckily I have quite a few for Nightwings. The almost bat-like nose I like to give to Nightwing characters is similar to the horn Hivewings have, and ended up working well. Another Nightwing headcanon of mine is in regards to their build and anatomy. I like drawing them almost like a quadruped dinosaur with shorter front legs and longer back legs and a raised tail. It's not as noticeable in this design as it is in a few of my other Nightwing designs, but that would make sense given it's a hybrid. I also tried to make the wings more similar to a Hivewings, but also added some of the classic stars. As for the coloring, I weirdly enough found myself inspired by a sort of autumn patterning. This was the only design of the three that I didn't end up gathering reference photos for and kinda did what I felt like. I really, really like how it ended up and I love the asymmetry on the legs especially. While I feel there are quite a few empty and blank spots on the face, neck, and side, I really like how this one turned out and had a lot of fun with it. I ended up naming the character Apis, which is a Latin word for bee, which I stumbled upon while googling bees named after stars and discovered the obscure history of Musca Borealis, a now unused constellation originally named Apis. I feel like I'm butchering these Latin words. Well, there they are. I had a lot of fun with this, despite the fact that my hand was injured while drawing two of these. As I'm sure you're aware, designing characters is one of my favorite things to do, and I've gotten loads of comments asking me about my process for designing characters. I hope that if you're one of those people who's asked me about that in the past, this is helpful insight into my process, inspirations, and designing. Also, sorry if you were hoping to name the characters, but I continue to receive comments on the last video from people who have suggestions, and apparently, didn't read the description or pinned comment letting them know I have already chosen names. Those comments, while all lovely and nice, were very tiring to read and receive 11 months after the video's upload. I hope you understand. Anyways, thank you for watching. This was a lot of fun to make, and I really enjoyed doing this again. I hope you have a lovely day or evening, and I'll see you in the next one.